Hello everyone, now we are going to discuss about the class Anthozoa. Class Anthozoa, we are also calling it as the Actinozoa. We are also calling it as the Actinozoa. And Anthozoans, always they are consisting of a polypoid form. Polypoid form, it means what? They are consisting of only polyp, not medulla is absent here. They are sedentary. Sedentary, it means what actually? They are single, not colonial. And most of the Anthozoans are sessile, that means they can't move, they are attached to the substratum here. And coelenteron is divided into many mesenterons. That means many divisions particularly. Many divisions here. Right? And then mesoglia is present here particularly in this Anthozoans. Mesoglia is present particularly in this Anthozoans here. Mesoglia is present. And the nidocytes which are there, they are the cells particularly. Nidocytes are formed from or found in ectodermal and endodermal cells. Nidocytes are the cells present in the cnidarians. We are calling it nidocyte cells particularly. They are found in what? Ectodermal, endodermal. They are found from the ectodermal and endodermal parts here. Particularly germ cells which we had. Actually germ cells are always endodermal in origin. So the endodermal layer, what is happening here? Germ cells or reproductive cells are produced in what? Produced in particularly class Anthozoans. Examples, if you are taking up the Anthozoans here, Adamsia or sea anemone, Coralium rubrum, it is a precious red stone coral. Then Georgia sea fan and Penna tuleta. Tuleta is a sea pen. These are the examples of the Anthozoans or Actinozoans particularly here, right? This is about the characteristics. These are the characteristics of what? These are the characteristics of the Actinozoans or Anthozoans here. Actinozoans or Anthozoans belongs to what? Belongs to the phylum Cnidaria. That means Cnidaria characters, they are consisting of, as we know, Cnidaria is divided into three classes mainly. Hydrozoa, Scyphozoa, Anthozoa. This is Anthozoa. Anthozoa is also known as Actinozoa here. And Anthozoa consisting of different examples we are getting. And remember, very very important point here, Anthozoans are always, they are consisting of only polypoid form. Right? Not the medusa form here. Right? This is about the Anthozoans.